We got this snap and rack system on these solar panels, and they directly screwed into the shingle, but this is gonna shrink throughout time because you could imagine how hot the shingles get. And you can see it has wiggle room. Look at that. You do want to install a flashing like this. So you have to make sure that water is shedding properly so it always sheds onto material. Just like this. Water's gonna go that way, as opposed to a screw, they just screwed onto the actual shingle without water shedding back onto the shingle. So if water enters in through here, it'll find its way through the screw and then it'll leak. In California, you get away with it because they just want to make the quick sell. But you see, same thing over here. They didn't even screw this one down. Look at this. So this one's not even screwed. Same thing right here. There's no water getting diverted here. I know this bolt is a little higher. You don't want to rely on screws without putting a proper flashing like this. So they tuck it, they try to say that this is a flashing, but this isn't, the water's not gonna get into here. This is fine. It's a flashing, tucks underneath the shingle. But this is fine, because water will come here, go onto the metal, and back onto shingle. The problem is this screw underneath, this bracket connects to this rail. So this is a separate piece, and this is separate, and then this is separate. So at first you install this, and then you install this L bracket with the screw. I don't know if there's sealant. I don't think there is sealant underneath there, but as I said before, it's the same thing as if you were to just screw into the shingle. If this was lifted up a little bit higher and this was sealed and like over here, there's no way. This whole flashing set, this diverts water back onto shingle, and it's lifted up all the way to right here. And the neck is sealed right here, or the collar, or the flashing. So the water would have to go pretty high in order for it to fill up here. That's why you have to be careful with solar, because they don't like to do two visits. They want to just come ruin your roof. Look at that. L bracket screwed in. It's the same thing as if you were to do this over here. This is actually better because at least they put sealant. I mean, even though it only lasts, depending on how much weather, sunlight it receives, and then it'll fill. But as I said before, there's lots of wiggle room there. You can literally lift this up. Yeah, be careful with solar. So I wanted to do this quick video regarding solar. Look at these. They put, instead of flashing, they put, they just put a lag bolt. And this is a very common problem nowadays. Supposed to have a flashing underneath there. There's not that many enforcers out there that are finishing for this, so a lot of solar companies get away with doing this just because it's faster, and then they charge for you to take off the panels in order for us to repair that. And this is a brand new roof, and they just penetrated it just like if this is okay. And they also put their anchors right here. they just had a hole right here, and they said that that's waterproof because there's a flashing underneath here and things like that. They get away with a lot of stuff, and very hard to make them to come back out here and fix their problems. So the homeowner wants us to come back out here and fix it for them. But unfortunately, if it was us installing it, we wouldn't have done none of that. We do it is more like this. So there's a flashing. So the flashing nice and cut around. This sheds water better. Because what shingles are, they're a water shedding product, not a waterproofing product. So any hole could cause a leak. There's been countless times where I've seen homeowners had mold problems because constant water going into their home, and the solar companies take like 6 months or 5 weeks to come out there, and it's the big problem. So we're trying to save homeowner money by doing everything right. And solar is one of those contractors right now that are doing a lot of people wrong and just needs to stop. And we need to see how we can, us as roofers, need to unite to let these homeowners know not to get solar. So first things first, whenever you replace shingles though, so you don't scuff them up, especially new ones. You want to get one of these. That way when you're working in a certain area, especially when it gets hot, your shoes don't mess up the shingles. And then you can put all your tools and things like that on there. Like this. Trash, anything. That way you don't damage the actual shingle. Because anything could damage them at this point. Change out a shingle. You gotta take off the nails, probably to the ridge, in order for you to properly install them. So, show you that. So I just removed all the damaged shingles and the ridge went all the way up. Now time to install the new shingles, and that's how you do it. So you see right here, they do the same thing on tile. I'll show you a quick video where I could show you how to do it with shingles and tile.
Also a different way of putting on tile so it looks good.
So right here you see that I didn't nail through the tile. This tile is held up by expanding foam made by DuPont. So that way we don't penetrate the shingle.
You put polyfoam or Wacaflex, whatever's better.
Now you only use Wacaflex when you want water to get back onto tile. Since we shingled all the way down to the eave on this one, we didn't want water to go backwards. So what we did was the foam method.
Just when we used polyfoam because of this big area right here.
So originally this house was a full clay tile roof. However, it was leaking underneath the panels because of broken tiles. So the homeowner wanted us to come out here and fix it. So we do work with solar companies that are willing to come out and do two visits. This process would be for them to come out, install their solar stanchions, and then we would come roof it in, and they would come after us to reinstall the panels. This is the racking system we use. I'll put the link in the description below. You see how these flashings are way better for water shedding. You see how these stanchions are properly flashed, just like your plumbing vents, your HVAC vents, your furnace vents. It allows for water to shed properly off of your shingles.
This is how it looks, how it's supposed to be. That way no water goes that way, and none of this water comes this way. Just wanted to do this quick video on how you go from solar, where there's shingles, to tile. For here, you put a tile pan for this side, like if it were for a chimney. It has a bend, and then the tin shingles go underneath this bend right here. And you step flash it, and you get that. That's how you do it. This roof right here was perfect for me to show you how to properly flash your stanchions on both tile and shingle. This isn't the only way you could get creative on properly flashing your stanchions. There are other ways and remedies depending on the situation. In this situation, the homeowner did have a sprinkler system on his roof to clean his panels. The sprinkler system was literally on his roof. So he requested us to leave 2 feet around the perimeter of the panels so he could get the sprinkler system serviced every now and then, and also in case he had to get one of his solar panels serviced as well. Typically, most homeowners want their tiles as close to the panels as possible so it can look like a tile roof. You can do that. However, for this homeowner, he didn't want any more broken tiles because that was his initial problem. I told him he should be fine because there are shingles installed underneath the panels as opposed to just tile and underlayment. He didn't want to take any chances. I don't blame him. Probably do the same thing if I had clay tiles. But if you do like a cleaner look, you can install tiles closer to the panels using the DuPont foam. Be sure whenever you have a solar installation to hire a roofing contractor to help coordinate with the solar company. We do have some solar companies that are willing to do this process located here in San Diego. You can find our company's information down in the description below. And if you watched this video this far, I have a bonus tip for you. Don't install solar on a roof that's about 30 years old. If you install solar on a 30-year-old roof, chances are it'll leak in the next year or two. Then the solar companies will charge you about $150 to $400 per panel, depending on the situation, of course. On top of that, you would have to replace your roof. It's always best to have roof and solar installed at the same time, because they both have a similar life expectancy. Well, that's all I have for you folks. If you did enjoy this content, please give it a like and subscribe and hit the bell notification if you would like to get our updates on our new videos. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.